Right now, jury selection underway in a highly anticipated murder trial. George Zimmerman, accused of killing Trayvon Martin, is pleading not guilty, saying he shot the teenager in self-defense. Prosecutors say the killing of Trayvon Martin was unjustified and charged Zimmerman with second-degree murder. So what are defense attorneys and prosecutors looking for in prospective jurors? Tad Nelson is a former prosecutor who rejoins us now. John Manuelian, criminal defense attorney. These cases are won and lost in jury selection, aren't they, Tad? What is the prosecution going to be looking for as they pick these six jurors?
You're absolutely, John. They are won and lost in jury selection. And, you know, you're trying to accomplish a couple goals in jury selection. Number one, you want to teach the jury the law. You want to let them know what the law is and how it applies to this case. The second thing you're trying to do is you're trying to weed out the people with the biases. And, you know, the ones that have real strong conviction, you know, the gun owners, the people that are okay, you know, with like using deadly force, you know, against people that come on their property. But nowadays, John, things have changed. You've got to worry about the third type of problem, the person who we call them a lurker. They sit there, they answer your questions the way they think you want them to answer them because they have an agenda. They have an agenda to be on that jury. They're the scariest. They're the absolute scariest.
Yeah. How do you sort those people out, John?
Experience. You have to know whether or not they're answering your questions truthfully. You've got to be good at voir dire. You've got to be engaged with them during the jury selection process. It's a chess match, and if you're not picking quality jurors and if you're not asking the correct questions, you're going to get a faulty jury. And I personally believe that the jury trial is won and lost during the jury selection.
Sure. Yeah, but everybody in Florida, everybody in the country practically has heard about this case. How, Tad, do you set about sorting out those people who might be sympathetic toward your argument?
Well, John, we call it voir dire down here in Texas, but the number one thing you have to do, you know, we got a jury for OJ. We got a jury for Casey Anthony. We can get a jury of people that either don't know enough or are not locked into a bias.
Yeah.
But just like John said, you've got to have experience. You've got to have a feel for what those people are telling you.
Just a few seconds
again,
left.
Again, I go right back to it.
Let me give John a chance to answer. Yeah, we got an OJ for a jury for OJ, but look at the verdict we got.
Yeah.
John?
Yeah, and you know, I don't think we're going to have that kind of problem here. I think that the jurors are more advanced since the concept of television. OJ was one of the first trials that was televised. I think jurors are more keen to what's going on, and I just think that you're not going to have that same problem here in the Zimmerman case.
All right. John Manuelli and Tad Nelson, the jury selection getting underway today in the Trayvon Martin shooting. Thank you both.
Thank you.